What's good YouTube, back with another banger video. If you haven't already read the title, this is a beginner's dribble tutorial, all right, on keyboard for keyboard players. This is 2K21 current gen PC edition. The game came out free on Epic Games a couple weeks ago, so a lot of people stopped playing the game because they didn't know how to dribble because they didn't have a controller. So I'm here for y'all. Don't forget to like, subscribe, so then other people can learn how to dribble. But yeah, I'm about to go into the mod court right now, and I'll see y'all right in there. Okay, before I get to the dribbling and how to dribble, this is my dribble moves. If y'all want it, here y'all go. Really, what I'm gonna be teaching you in this video is nothing really that complicated. Like, you could really do it on most dribble moves. What I'm gonna be showing you here, but yeah, this is my dribble moves. This is what I use. You guys can use them. Go ahead. But yeah, I'll see. I'm about to go into the mod court, and I'll see y'all there. What's good, y'all? I'm in the mod court, and how to do this? You would go down on your phone. You would invite somebody, and then you would go into personal workout. That's all the way down on when you're picking like something to do on the mod court. And yeah, that's how you get this personal workout and stuff like that. So what I'm gonna be teaching y'all today is how to do a step back, how to do the crossover, how to do hesitations, how to do explosive behind the back, and how to do a curry slide. I'm gonna teach you guys how to do the crossover, which can go into a speed boost. And if you guys don't know how to do it, I'll just explain it real quick how to do a speed boost. So a speed boost would be, for example, if I do like a hesitation, right? I wait a second, you get a speed boost, and you can just go right to the basket or do whatever you want with it, anything like that. And yeah, that's really a speed boost. It's really that simple. But now what you need is a 100% keyboard. If I didn't say this already, you need a 100% keyboard to do dribble moves, stuff like that. So how do you do the crossover? The crossover is super simple. It's probably the simplest thing you guys are going to be learning in this dribble tutorial. Is the only thing you're clicking is the 8 button. The 8 button on the right side of your keyboard. Is the 8 button. That's literally it. And you can just spam it. And you're probably going to get this animation if you keep spamming it, like how fast I'm spamming it. But if you wait, you get that animation, and you could just keep doing it. So yeah, and this animation you're probably gonna use in the most out of everything. You're probably gonna use the most out of everything that you're learning today. And so right, so you just click 8 like fast, click 8 fast, click 8 slow. You're gonna get the animation. Hold it. You're gonna get this animation. So you want to click it fast and wait, and then you're able to do a speed boost off of that, and that's a speed boost animation that you're able to speed boost off of that animation, and you're probably going to use that the most out of everything. So it's pretty self-explanatory. If you don't know how to do a hezzy on a controller, this is how you do it on a keyboard. It's the same thing. You would, if the ball's on your left hand and you want to do a hezzy standing still, you click on the left side. If you wanna bring the ball through your legs onto the right hand, you would click the other. You would click 6. You'll do the same thing. You would click 4 if the ball's on your right hand and you wanna get to your left hand, and you would go through your legs. If you wanna get it to your right hand, you would click 6. Or you could use use 8, which I think would be easier. But yeah. But if you want to do a hesitation, you would just flick the side. You would click the button on the side the ball's on. So for example, if the ball's on my right hand, you would click 6, and I get a hesitation. And you're able to, and that's how you get a hesitation. But that's standing hesitation. There's a difference between a moving hesitation and standing. Standing, you can't really do anything. You'd still get a speed boost animation off of it. But yeah. But what a lot of people use is the moving hesitation, and it's the same thing as standing, but you're moving. So pretend I'm moving to the right, I would click 6 and I get the moving hesitation. If I want to do it on the left hand, I would click 4 and you get the moving hesitation, and you're able to, after doing that, you're able to combo up. You're able to do a combo of pretends on my right hand, 6 and 8, 4 and 8, and it's really that easy if you want to do a moving hesitation. Now, moving hesitation, you would probably use if you want to do a speed boost, right? Speed boost like that. Go anything really, watch like this. Do a step back. You just, I don't know, I'll just shoot in it. But yeah, something like that. And that's how you would dribble, and that's how you do a hesitation on keyboard. And now, so I'm gonna teach you guys how to do a step back. What I mean by step back is this move. And now it's literally the same thing. It's literally the same thing as 8, but you don't even have to be running. You can be running and do it. You can be running and do it. You don't have to be sprinting and do it. Like, it's literally this. It's literally another simple move. It's super simple. You only have to click 2. So if you want to do the step back, you only have to click 2. And this is another thing that you would probably be using a lot in your dribbles and your combos, stuff like that. Now, I'm not gonna teach you guys how to do like spin moves, because that's pretty difficult on keyboard, because you have to do a lot of things. But yeah, this is how you would do a step back on keyboard, and you can also like combo up on it like that, if I haven't already said that. So yeah, it's really that easy. Like, for hesitation, it's literally the same thing like that, and it's that easy. So this video is probably not gonna be that long, because a lot of things is pretty easy to learn, because keyboard is you're able to see the keyboard on my thing, and it's not going fast. You're able to see the buttons pretty slowly, what I'm doing. And yeah, but anyways, so I'm gonna move on to the next thing, and I'm teaching you guys how to do a curry slide, because curry slide is kind of the same thing as explosive, but it'll be easier if you learn the curry slide first before explosive. So curry slide is pretty simple. Like, literally everything on keyboard is pretty simple, but you guys have the mentality of, bro, this is gonna be hard. So okay, how to do a curry slide. So you're holding two buttons. You're holding two buttons down. You're gonna hold 2 and 6 down. If the ball's in your left hand, you're holding 2 and 6 down. And now here's an example. So I'm holding, so the ball's in my left hand, I'm gonna be holding 2 and 6 down. Now watch. Now I don't have the 6 for a curry slide, but this is how you do a curry slide. If you have the right animations and stuff like that, if you have the right animations, this is how you would do a curry slide. And if it's on your right hand, you do the opposite. So you would hold 2 and 4 down, and you'd get that thing. And you're able to spam this as much as you want, but you're gonna run out of stamina, right? So yeah, that's how you do a curry slide on keyboard. And you could do this off of anything, really. So for example, off that hesitation, it's basically like curry slide that you see like people that dribble on keyboard and that use curry slide. I mean, not dribble on keyboard, dribble on a controller. It's not that hard. It's like you're only holding two buttons down, and it's crazy how people think it's like super hard, but it really isn't that hard. Do curry slide is you hold, so if it's on your right hand, you do 4 and 2. That's a curry slide. If it's on your left hand, you hold 2 and 6, and that's a curry slide. Now, and that's really it. Now, so the explosive behind the back is a little difficult. On keyboard, it's there's certain animations and like places that you gotta be, like what your character did before doing it, to be able to do another explosive behind, like doing an explosive behind the back. So for example, right here, I'm able to do explosive behind the back, but after this, whoops, I did that wrong. So for example, I'm right here. Okay, I'm messing this up. All right, for example, I'm standing still. I could do explosive behind the back, right? I'm standing still. I'm doing explosive behind the back. But it's like sometimes you would get an animation. So for example, I'm doing that, and then you get this animation. I'm still doing the same thing as the explosive behind the back, but I get this animation. So you have to get out of that animation, or if I find out, I'll find out how to like do an explosive behind the back after that, I'll put it in an advanced dribble tutorial when I come out with one. So the places that I've learned that you're able to do an explosive behind the back is the step back, explosive behind the back, step back, explosive behind the back, the step back, explosive behind the back, step back, explosive behind the back, explosive behind the back. You could do hesitation, explosive behind the back, hesitation, explosive behind the back, hesitation, explosive behind the back. And you could do like that. And it's like, you could do a lot of things with it. So let's do, you could do it off of that. There's like, you have to have momentum to it. So it has to be like a momentum thing. You have to have momentum. So it has, you like, you can't be doing like stuff like this where like, it's like, you have to be patient with it. Because if you're too fast, like let me show you, you're just gonna get that animation, and it's just gonna be sloppy. Because in an actual game, it's not gonna really work out like that. Because they're an actual person guarding you if they haven't left. So that's how you really do an explosive behind the back. You can slow down. You can go back, slow down a video, and see how to do it. I'm gonna try to do it slow for you guys right here. So you would hold. So okay, I didn't really tell you guys this. So what you would hold. So if it's on your left hand, you'd hold A and D, W and D. You would hold W and D, and 2 and 6. So pretend you're doing a curry, but you're also doing W and D. So curry slide, W D, 2 6. So explosive behind the back, W D, 2 6. Curry slide, 2 6. If it's on your left hand. So curry slide like that. Let me get on my left hand and explosive behind the back like that. So you're holding 4 buttons down. Now if it's on your right hand, it's literally the same thing, but 4 different buttons, or 3 actually. You're holding A W at 4 2. So how you do curry slide on your right hand, F 2. If you wanna do explosive behind the back, you do. You would include WA, and then you do 4 2 WA, so like that. Or actually, that was wrong. Hold up, like this. I kept doing that. Oh my god, like that. And so like this, like that, and it's like it's. If you think about it, it's not that hard. It's just like you just have to get used to it. That's all that you really got to do. You have to get used to it. So I wouldn't say this is too complicated, because you're only including one button. So pretend you're doing a dribble, pretend you're comboing up like that, like this, pretend you're dribbling. You do step back, you hold shift, and you shoot the ball. Now, if you do that same thing, here, let me see. I'll do the same thing. Do that, you would do a fadeaway. You do a fadeaway. But if you do hold shift at the end of that, because that's a quick stop, right? You do the same thing, right? Oh, wait. So watch. So I click shift, and it stops the fadeaway. So like, watch this. I could just stop there. I click shift and but yeah, it's really that simple, and it's crazy how simple it is. It's like people think keyboard is like a menace to society, like it's super hard, but it really isn't that hard when you take the time to look at it and see how it works. But yeah, that's really I wanted to show you guys. That's what I've learned, at least from me doing like me labbing in the my court and stuff like that. Be playing games. I find new stuff out, and I'll put it in the advanced dribble tutorial for you guys. So yeah, that's really it. I hope this helps anybody that plays on keyboard. You know, a lot of people say I'm a demon just for being able to learn how to dribble on keyboard. It's like it took a while because, you know, there's nobody that's out here making a video on how to dribble on a keyboard. I've definitely checked, and so I spent like a couple hours learning stuff and just been comboing up on in the my court, sorry. And it's been a struggle, but I've gone through it. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope this helped you guys a lot. Don't forget to like and subscribe, because, you know, I'm teaching people out here, and it's like people don't know, and people are stressing out because they can't play the game because they don't know how to dribble. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I spent some time on it. You don't know how many times I've had to redo this because I've messed up. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please like, subscribe. It means a lot. It's super appreciated. And I think that's gonna be it for the video. And I hope you guys have an amazing day. I'll see y'all later. Peace. What the hell?